Let's start with an overview of the topic of software requirements. We'll be emphasizing embedded software requirements issues, but in general, the topics we'll talk about apply to all software systems. Some anti-patterns for software requirements are, if your requirements are not written down, that will cause problems. Another anti-pattern is if you have incomplete or imprecise requirements. Another anti-pattern is the requirements exist, but they all look like be just like the last version except do this thing, which leaves you without baseline requirements. Requirements are essential to a successful software project. Requirements faults, missing requirements, defective requirements can defeat a design before it's even built. Requirements are there to describe what the system does, and especially for mission-critical systems, requirements also need to say what's not supposed to happen. They need to use precise, testable language, and ideally, every requirement traces to a system test that's designed to make sure that requirement was actually fulfilled. It's commonly said that many, if not most, major software failures trace back to bad requirements. By the time you have a big software development disaster and project failure, there's usually plenty of blame to go around. But an example of a time when it was clear that requirements really contributed to a big software failure is the FBI Virtual Case Project. Approximately $170 million were wasted on this project that never was completed and was thrown away in favor of a new project in 2005. The idea was to automate the handling of all the files for the FBI. And right out of the gate, the project had problems, starting with requirements were not actually defined when the development contract was signed. So apparently they signed a contract saying build us some software, but the contract did not say what the software was supposed to do. That should have been a red flag right there. Early on, it was said that the requirements amounted to, give it a try, we'll know it when we see it. While that approach might be good for requirements elicitation and early exploration, it's not a sound basis for developing a major piece of software in the middle of the project. Unsurprisingly, there were repeated requirements changes. Some of them were from we'll know it when we see it, but others were because they had not considered all the different users of the system, and it turned out that different users had significantly different requirements. In the end, they had scope creep, which is new requirements being added, of 80%. A number of other things went wrong, and eventually they pulled the plug on the project. The takeaway here is that if you don't have reasonable requirements at the beginning of a project, it's probably going to be downhill from there. To be clear, you're unlikely to have perfect, absolutely complete requirements on day one. But if you do not have a reasonable starting point, the project is going to have problems.